After decades of neglect, India has made significant inroads in road infrastructure development. By March 20 this year, India has built around 1,37,625 kilometers of highways compared to only 91,287 kilometers in April 2014. Further, the government plans to spend around 15 lakh crore rupees to construct roads and highways across the country in the next 2 years. Today, in this episode of Industry Unplugged, we are pleased to welcome Mr. Anand Sundaresan, who is the Managing Director of Ammann India. He will explain the role of advanced technology in achieving India's road building targets. He is also going to tell us how his company is keeping pace with this kind of technology transformation. So welcome, Mr. Sundaresan, sir.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
Thank you, sir. Sir, India has achieved the record-breaking milestone of constructing around 37 kilometers highways per day in the year 2020-21. So how do you see the role of advanced technologies in achieving such kind of such a milestone?
If you look at it, the achievement of 37 kilometers of road per day, it is not a joke. You know, it is something substantial. And if somebody has to achieve this kind of road per day, on a per day basis, then, you know, unless and until there is full-fledged mechanization, it is impossible to do that. Okay. So in National Highway, if you look at it, in the olden time, people are using or from the golden quadrilateral time, you know, it started using bigger capacity plants. Even the capacity of the plant were specified, and all modern machines are used in road building. So now people are not even, whatever the government is specifying that you use, let us say, about 120 cubic meter of plant, they're not using 120 cubic meter of plant. In case of concrete, I'm talking about, there's many of the contractors have even used the double the capacity of the plant in order to speed up the work. Same way, in case of asphalt, if you look at it, you know, previously people are using 120 tons plant. Now, you know, nobody is using 120 ton plant for the National Highway project. They are either going for 180 ton plant or even 260 ton plant. So the capacities of the plant which is being used here is very, very big, number one. Number two is that all this, so because the production is so high, all the balancing equipment which goes along with that, whether it is tipper, whether it is dumper, whether it is paver, all the things are also of very high capacity. So all these things, and all of them are really most modern and state-of-the-art technology we are using in the road building. So all these things have brought in the kind of the mileage, I mean, the kind of numbers with respect to the per day construction of road that we have achieved here. So that is technology and the use of modern machines have really played a very, very important role in this great achievement.
So apart from attaining speed in kind of the construction, what has been happening today, road making has witnessed a complete transformation in terms of cost and material efficiency as well. So what's your comment on this particular context?
See, number one, of course, cost is also equally important. You know, when just because, you know, we want to build so many kilometers of road per day, if the cost is going to be 2 times, 3 times, then it doesn't make sense at all. Definitely, the cost also has to be under control. No doubt about that. By using, in place of, let's say, a 100-ton plant, if they're using a 200-ton plant, automatically the cost comes down, in my opinion, because the number of operators, the number of people that are required, that itself is very low. Plus, your turnaround time is much faster. So like that, if by use of bigger capacity equipment, all that itself brings down the cost of the equipment itself, number one. The second thing is that, if you see these plants, whatever we are supplying, if you take the case of the asphalt plant, a lot of new things have come. Like, you know, use of a special type of burners where the fuel consumption becomes much lower. So thereby the fuel cost of becomes much, much lower. Or many other things, you know, use of recycling material. And those sort of things have also been implemented, which has overall brought down the cost of construction. So these are some of the things which initiative that has been taken, and that's how the cost is also kept under control.
are you witnessing a kind of, you know, attraction in the demand for innovative technologies, what you are seeing, which are already available in the Western countries?
100%. You know, see, many of our contractors, see, one thing you have to understand, our contractors are very well educated. They are very quite knowledgeable. It is, you know, we have been, you know, after the Golden Dattolattal project has come, after National Highway has taken up the project and setting up all the road projects here, the Indian contractors have graduated. They have learned a lot. They have really learned a lot in the sense that, you know, the now they are traveling worldwide, trying to understand what is being done in the other countries. And many of them are learning from there, and they have come back and they have implemented even much better system in India. So if you see some of the big contract like contractors like ZR Infra, APCO, or HG Infra, all these big contractors, they are all far ahead. They are all, you know, doing fantastic job by using modern machines and modern equipment and in completing their in doing their projects, irrespective of whether it is really necessary to go for such type of high cost equipment. They are doing that.
So have you introduced any product in the recycling segment and green equipment what you are talking about?
Yes, we have already done that. We have got particular thing which we are, but you know, it's not being very extensively used, even though in the recent past we have seen that many customers are coming forward and asking for the recycling equipment from us. So we have some plant where we can use it, use up to 60% of the recycled material we can use. You know, for example, if it is a greenfield project, then the question of using a recycled does not arise because there is no road. But when you are talking about road widening or expansion or something like that, then there is a possibility to use a recycled material. That is why I said, first of all, we have to build the road, and only after that we'll be able to use the recycled material in this. So that will be the future. Yeah. Exactly. Then the other thing that is coming is use of plastic. We are doing some experiment on that, and probably, you know, in the future, plastic will be used on the road. So we have some equipment for that. And also some fibers will be used on the road. So we are also working on those areas.
There are quite a few players in the road building equipment segment, those who are doing, including Ammann, those who are doing exceptionally well during the past decade. Where do you position Ammann as a company in this segment?
Well, Ammann is very known only for asphalt plants and the asphalt road building. We are not so, at least in India, for example, we are not very well known in with respect to the concrete plants or with respect to compactors and all. These are products which has been acquired by Ammann few years ago, you know, one after the other. For example, the compactor business was acquired by them. The concrete business was acquired by them some 6-7 years ago. So these are all the add-on products. So they are all quite new for the Ammann family. But when you talk about asphalt plant, Ammann is the very leading player right from the beginning. They are into asphalt plant. So we would like to be definitely a leading player with respect to asphalt plant. There is no doubt about that. So we would be a very, very important player in the road building machinery business in India. And in certain areas, if you look at it, there are not many players. Okay, in compactors, maybe there are a lot of players. But in pavers, not many. So, you know, we can create, so that's a niche product. So there we can become a very important player in that market. Asphalt plant, similarly, you know, there are a handful of people in that market. I mean, I'm talking from the organized segment. There are unorganized segment, there are plenty. There are hundreds of people who produce continuous plants. But continuous plants are not the one which are used in the national highway projects. So basically, they're all bass plants. There are only one or two other people, but they're not so involved or so much committed in the Indian market like Ammann is committed. So we are very much committed to the Indian market. We are expecting that the industry will grow, and we would like to be a very, very important player in this growth.
Earlier we were discussing about the government's target of expanding it to 40 kilometers road a day, and you also touched about the kind of product what you are going to bring into the Indian market. So with that, are you going to expand your production capacity?
Well, frankly, to tell you the truth, you know, just about 2 years ago only, three years ago, Ammann invested almost 180 crores in India, and a new facility was set up in Mesana, with a, you know, in an area of about 33 acres, with very modern machines, robotics, and all these things for producing the for producing asphalt plant, and also the pavers and compactors. So we have just done the investment. But at the same time, having said that, we are not, we will not shy away from making any investment if it is necessary and if we find that there is a need for making further investment. The as I said, you know, Ammann management is extremely conscious about what's happening in India, and they are very much interested in the Indian market. They are interested in the Indian market, they are also very much interested in the Indian company itself, because India provides a very good location for them also to sell the products out of India to some of the overseas market. In fact, we are already doing export sales from India. Now that area has to be strengthened, and probably we have to increase it there also. So Ammann India is a very, very important part of the Ammann group. So we will do whatever is necessary to grow this and strengthen the Indian market. Right. I mean, the Indian company.
So yeah. Are you even open for any kind of merger and acquisitions if you are?
Ammann is a company which diversified into some of the other products only by way of acquiring some companies. For example, if you see the roller business, what we are doing, roller business was never in Ammann fold, but they acquired a company in Europe, and then that is how we got into the roller business, because that has got something to do with the road business. The same way, Elba, which is a company from Germany, they produce concrete batching plants, structures and pumps they used to produce in the past. So that company was acquired by Ammann, and that is how they got into the concrete business. So like that, Ammann is known to diversify, but limited to road construction business. So if there are some companies which are available, and if it is attractive, and that's going to make, if it is going to bring any synergy in what we are doing, then definitely we are we will not shy away from that. We will keep our eyes and ears open to see what's happening there, and we would like to participate in that as well. But I don't think that in India there is any other company which is a target at this point of time.
You are heading the business of Ammann in India and have significant numbers of decades of experience in this particular field, construction equipment as well as the road building segment. So what are your some of your long and short term objectives to achieve for Ammann in India?
Our objective is to strengthen the Ammann India as much as possible and substantially improve the quality of the product which is coming out of this particular product, be exactly in line with the quality requirements of the worldwide, bring it to the worldwide standards, quality standards, and then not only participate in the Indian market, but also be a hub for supplying equipment out of India to the global requirement. So that is our long-term perspective. So initially, we will start with concentrating more on India, SAARC countries, and some of the countries where we are already exporting. But in the future, I think, you know, it should be open for anything. We should try to produce. There are a lot of companies who have done that in India. You know, it's not only Ammann which is new for that. For example, if you take many companies, I can name it, you know, they started in a small way, they improved their quality. And now you can see that in the world, many countries, they have, earlier they were a little bit reluctant to take products from India, but then nowadays it's not like that. So they're quite open to taking products from India. So I think we can also participate in that in a very, very big way. That is our one of the targets. The other target, of course, to make Ammann as the name in the name in the road construction equipment business in India.
Thank you, Mr. Sundaresan, for being on our show today and explaining the role of advanced technology in accelerating India's road infrastructure development. Thank you so much for sharing all the details. With that, it's our next interaction with Mr. Anand Sundaresan, Managing Director of Ammann India. Viewers, Thanks for watching Mojo for Industry, India's first mobile journalism platform for industry. Please stay tuned for more such interactions and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon. Goodbye.